Hello students, in my today's video, I am going to explain you the question answer of lesson 3, the Turkish cap. Now, for questions, come to the page number 22 and I will explain the answers. Lesson 3, question answers. Question 1. Where did the boys usually play gulli danda? Why didn't they play in their school compound? Now, for answers, see. The boys played gulli danda in a ground near their school. They didn't play in their school compound as it was too small. Because their school compound was too small, so they were used to playing it outside the school compound. Now, question number 2. What happened when the narrator was just about to catch the gulli flying towards him? Answer. When the narrator was just about to catch the gulli flying towards him, it knocked off the Turkish cap of a man and landed inside the cap. Question 3. What were the narrator and his friends doing when the man was complaining to the headmaster? Question mark. Don't forget to put question mark at the end of each question. Answer. The narrator and his friends were standing outside and praying silently. Slowly, they crept to the courtyard facing the headmaster's room to try and listen to the conversation they were having and the consequences. Okay? Now, come to the next question, question number 4. Why did the narrator and his friends feel like laughing in the headmaster's room? Because instead of being completely angry, the headmaster was impressed by the Kushal's stroke that knocked the man's cap off and then land the gulli inside the cap. Now, next question, question number 5. Was the headmaster genuinely angry with the boys? Answer, no. The headmaster was not genuinely angry with the boys because he had not punished them in any way. This shows that he was not angry because he has not given any punishment to the boys for playing outside. Number 6. Why did the man with the Turkish cap look amused at the end? Yes, at the end, the Turkish cap man also looked amused as the headmaster behaved with the students. The answer. The man with the Turkish cap looked amused at the end because he too perhaps agreed that Kushal's stroke was a master stroke. He was also amused because he also think that was the master stroke which put off my cap. Now, these all are the question answers of lesson 3. First, you have to write C, then answer the following question and you have to put the date also. Date should be proper and then you should write like this as I have written in my notebook. This is the proper way to do question answers. Now, come to the page number 23 of your course book. And here, we will do exercise A and B. Okay? Here is the date. Now, colloquial words means conversational words or informal bol chal ki bhasha. Kabhi kabhi hum words actual kuch hote hain, but bol chal mein wo kuch bole jate hain jo ki normally log bolte hain. Theek hai? Unko colloquial words kehte hain. Jaise, come to the exercise A. Match the following colloquial words with their meanings. Words, colloquial words are here and the meanings are given here. First is chap. Chap means a man. Ballistic, suddenly angry or excited. Grub, food. Knackered, tired. Posh, fancy. Minted, very wealthy. In this exercise, you have to put only numbers. Don't draw the lines. No need to draw the lines. You have to write only proper numbers, numbering. You have to do numbering only. Clear, students? Don't draw the lines like this, as the nursery KG students do. Okay? You have to write only numbers here. And no need to write this work in your copies. You have to do these two exercises here only in this book. Okay? No need to write in the copy. Clear? Number B, fill in the blanks using the colloquial words from exercise A. You have to use these words to fill this exercise. Okay? Number one, our school was located in a posh area. Let's get some grub from the roadside stall. Number three, the crowd went ballistic when Ravi hit the ball. Number four, that chap was asking about you when you were not here. Number five, after her tennis practice, Madhuri was totally knackered. Number six, the jamindars who built these lavish mansions were absolutely minted. Now, in this way, we have completed exercise A and B of page number 23. Now, students, in this way, we have completed all the exercise of lesson 3. Okay? In this way, lesson 3 of course book completed. From my next video, I will explain your reader book. Okay? Wednesday, we will start reader. Okay? Now, your P periodic course is completed in course book. In this course book, you will, in pre-periodic chapter, only 3 chapters are coming. The pink card, leisure and the Turkish cap. And we have completed all these chapters. Thank you, students, for today's video.